A TSBVI Outreach Tutorial. APH Braille Print Protractor, Part 2, Features. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
And now we're going to get a little more close-up view of the APH Braille Print Protractor. Now, the Braille Print Protractor has several features, I think, that make it easier to use than most adapted protractors currently available. And there are other protractors out there. So I'm going to give you my prejudice here. It has bold, large print numbers on it, and they go, again, from on this particular one, from 0 to 180. Or 0 to 180 going the other direction. On the newer one, as you saw, it just does go in one direction. Now, bold, large, in addition to the bold, large print numbers, it has two Braille dots are used to mark degrees at 10 degree increments. So you can see there's 10, if we can get a little closer, we've got 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and so forth. All of those, everything that ends in a zero has two dots, except when we get up to 90, let's see if we can look. If we look at 90, it actually has three dots, and I will explain that later. So anything ending in a zero, which we have like zero and 180 are the only exceptions, and 90. So let's take a look at close up at zero. It actually has three dots. 180, which is at the other extreme, has three dots, and the 90 has three dots. With that exception of those three numbers ending in zero, all of the other ones, the 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and so forth, have two dots. Okay, I want to make sure I'm saying that very clearly. And the reason for the 90, the 0, and the 180 having the three dots will become apparent in just a moment. Okay, now as far as one dot, if you look closely at the 5 degrees, it has one dot. So if you go around and if you count by fives, 5, 15, 25, 35, until you get to 45, and then you encounter those three dots again. And if you go all the way around and over here to until you get to actually 135, and let me get my hand out of the way there, you're going to notice you have three dots on the 135 as well. Okay, so you will have one dot when the number ends in 5, except for the 45 and the 135. So let's figure this out. What is going on with the three dots? Okay, the three dots really are at 0, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, 135 degrees, and 180 degrees. The reason for the three dots is because those are particular angle measurements, or in the case of the 0 and the 180, kind of starting and stopping points that are very important. So that's why we have the three dots. And also, it will help facilitate when we are actually measuring. So again, just to remind, okay, any number ending in a 0 is going to have two dots, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and then of course when we get to the 90 we have the difference, and so forth. Okay, anything ending in 5 is going to have one dot, so we have 5, 15, 25, 35, and then we get to the 45, we do have a difference there, but then continuing 55, 65, 75, and so forth, we have the one dot. And this is harder to try to explain than it is for the students to use, believe me. Okay, so probably the most important feature, and I want to get to that right away, is the wand. This is really what makes it so easy for our students. And when the pointed end of that wand is aligned with a degree measurement, the corresponding angle is formed by the extended straight edge of the wand and the edge or diameter of the protractor. And let me explain that. Let me go ahead and actually try an angle and show you what's going on. So I'm going to be doing a, now let me see what I'm going to do. I will do a 50 degree angle. If you're used to using a print one, you might be looking at this and going, well, how am I going to do that? A lot of people tell me, turn it upside down and you're able to see this much better. You have created your 50 degree angle here. So this is where the angle is formed. Again, it's formed by the wand. Let me get my hand out here. It's formed, and I'll use a pen just to kind of show you a little more easily. Okay, the angle is actually formed with the wand. This is your vertex going right where the wand joins the semicircle, and then coming along the edge of the semicircle portion or the diameter portion of the protractor, that's where your angle is formed. Okay. So, now, other attractive features is that the desired angle supplement is also formed. So, I just mentioned that I had this 50 degree angle on this side, but if we look over on the other side, we have its supplement formed, again, with the wand and the edge of the protractor itself. And this is its supplement. Now, what does supplement mean? Two angles are supplementary if their measurements add up to 180 degrees. So let's do a little math here, guys. If the one on this side is 50, the one on this side would be 180 minus 50, which is 130 degrees. So this is a very good teachable moment that you can talk about supplementary angles using this particular protractor. So another reason that I really like this particular protractor. Now, another attractive feature is its size and plastic flexibility, and I'll show you what I mean by that in just a moment. Again, it's plastic, and you can see I'll just kind of do a little flexing right now. And I mean, I wouldn't sit here and try to break it, but anyway, it's relatively small and flexible. And it can be used easily, I think, to measure most angles in textbooks, because sometimes textbooks have an angle that's very, very close to the binding. And furthermore, this protractor can be used independently to both draw and measure angles. And when I say independently, that's one of my big, big important words for our blind students. I want them to be able to do and create independently. So I'm going to show you now what it would be like to try to measure an angle in an actual textbook that has some binding.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Braille Print Protractor. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Program. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756, USA. Telephone, 512-454-8631. Website, www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009, all rights reserved.